Plastics are an essential part of our economy, and modern daily life is unthinkable without them. Yet, they can have serious effects on our health and our environment. Plastic can also be found in small sizes known as microplastics. These can be unintentionally formed when larger pieces of plastic are broken down, or they can be deliberately manufactured and intentionally added to products.
They're very diverse uses that we see in society, in cosmetics, in detergents. We also see them used in the life sciences industry, for example, and used in medical diagnostics.
In shampoo, in toothpaste, in lipsticks, the list is very, very long.
A microplastic is a material that has specific properties, and it can be made of many different sorts of polymer-based material. Polyethylene, nylon, these are materials which are known to exist in a form that would consider to be a microplastic, so particle, solid, and with dimensions less than 5 millimeters.
Probably the most well-known is the use of microplastic ingredients in cosmetics and personal care products. What a lot of people don't recognize is that the raw material of plastic production is also in the form of microplastics. These are the so-called pre-production plastic pellets that can also be in the form of flakes or powders. We often call them nurdles. And they're also easily spilled. We find them on a lot of beaches around the UK and around Europe. It's one of the biggest direct sources of microplastic pollution in the environment. And another similar source are the microplastic fibers from synthetic clothing.
It's for us not only the question about possible toxicity or effects that microplastic can have on the environment. It's really just bringing something in which you don't know how it will behave and which shouldn't be there. So just changing the natural system in some way.
I think a restriction on plastic in cosmetics or in detergents or in many other consumer products is very necessary. Consumers are unaware that plastics are even in there. They're very shocked when they hear about it. Consumers also don't want plastic in their products.
If they would know and understand and see what they are using, they would take the choice to take a product without microplastic.
They are in the products because they have a function. So we have several uses in the cosmetic industry, for example, in the detergent industry, but also very specific uses to encapsulate fertilizers or medicines.
And in paints and coatings, it's used for matting, abrasion resistance, scratch resistance.
Benefits are really huge. However, the environmental concern is really increasing in Europe and in the world.
Until we can sort of define benefit, it's we need to sort of really assess the potential for risk in those products.
Plastic is everywhere and can stay in our environment for hundreds of years. In the EU alone, we generate 25 million tons of plastic waste every single year. In fact, most of the waste we generate is plastic.
Plastics are forever. I think that's one of the main negative effects. It's very persistent.
Some estimates, perhaps up to 1,000 years for a single plastic bottle.
The EU has adopted its plastic strategy in January 2018. Actions are being taken to reduce plastic waste and address health and environmental concerns. So what is the issue with plastics?
We know that microplastics can be transferred up the food chain. They're readily eaten by a wide range of organisms, from mussels, plankton at the bottom of the food chain, to fish, turtles, whales. When they get eaten by these animals, they can transfer these toxic chemicals, and that can have knock-on impacts on the wider marine ecosystems and on human health.
If not properly disposed of, they can pollute the oceans and marine life, ending up on our plates and accumulating in our bodies through the food chain.
They do end up in the food chain, that's all proven, in the soils, water soils. So it gets into our system and it's almost impossible to clean it.
So what impact does this have on our health? Well, the answer is, we simply don't know.
There's lots of scientists that are working on this particular issue at the moment.
The findings, some report adverse effects, others don't. So the sort of pitch that we've got in terms of the research at the moment is really varied, and we still sort of need to fill in some of those gaps with a bit more research.
That's actually why we should avoid plastics getting into the environment. Really cut the problem at the source and regulate it.
The European Chemicals Agency is looking into the uses and risks of microplastics. Their aim? To identify whether microplastics in products should be restricted within the EU.
ECHA has been asked to look at that because we're responsible for the implementation of the REACH regulation, which is the EU's chemical regulation. So under REACH, we're looking at intentional uses of these materials as substances, but we're not able to look at these unintentional formation. And this is work that's being done elsewhere and led very much by the Commission under other parts of the plastic strategy.
Whether that plastic is actually causing a health risk or not to the environment, that's what we're assessing. And the next step is, what measures should we take to reduce that risk? Those measures that we would recommend the Commission to take clearly have an impact both on improving our environment and health, but also an impact on the industry.
The European plastics industry has a turnover of close to 350 billion euros annually. It employs over 1.5 million people, and close to 60,000 companies operate in the plastic sector.
If it's a total ban, my company is out of business, I guess, because we our main target or main market is paints and coatings.
Most of the products where microplastics are put into today were already in the market 20 years ago without microplastics. So it's possible to put these products on the market without them.
Any restriction that was proposed would have consequences on industry, because there would be a need maybe to reformulate products. There would be a need to use different risk management, for example.
Potential replacement of microplastics will be an opportunity for us, because we should do research in alternative materials. We could work, for example, in an alternative polymeric shell that could be biodegradable or, unless more environmentally friendly.
If we manage to restrict those uses that already have alternatives, we will reduce the emissions of microplastics into the environment, and then we will avoid all the negative impacts.
We have to move on. We don't have that much time anymore.